The other day I sat on my chair, and I was bored. I didn't really know what to do. And then it hit me. Let's speedrun! But I wanted something new, something I didn't speedrun before. So I searched the internet, website after website, searching for a game. And then I saw it. Celeste. If you don't know Celeste, it's a very famous 2D platformer. It's about a girl trying to climb a mountain, but it's actually her trying to fight anxiety or something, or depression. I don't really care about that. I care about speedrunning. I played some Celeste in the past, but let's say I'm not very good. Celeste has three main techniques: jumping, climbing, and most importantly for this speedrun, dashing. Oh wait, did I say three? I meant 87! Because I didn't want to waste my entire next 2 months on learning all of this stuff, I decided to give myself 1 hour to learn how to speedrun Celeste Chapter 2. The first thing I did before I started the timer is my first run. Rules are simple. First, the run starts when the in-game timer starts, and it ends when the in-game timer ends. Second, I have 1 hour and then I will do another run. So my first run was okay, to say the least. And the timer started. The first thing I did was to go to speedrun.com and watch other runners and how they did it. And well, you remember how I told you Celeste has like 87 different techniques? Well, they use some pretty hard ones. After that, I understood I have some learning to do, so I opened YouTube and started searching. After watching a few YouTube videos, I decided that the most important thing right now is to learn how to hyper dash. You remember dashing? Well, hyper dashing is like dashing, but cooler. To hyper dash, you need to hold down, dash, and jump. It might sound easy, but it's not. After using almost half an hour already, I decided to learn another technique, called extended hyper dash. The extended hyper dash is like the hyper dash, but even cooler. It allows you to use the momentum of the hyper dash, but still have another dash. You see, in Celeste, when you're in the air, you have one dash. If you use it, you won't be able to dash again. To regain the dash, you need to touch the ground. Extended hyper dash uses this mechanic to save the dash. Works by holding down, dashing, and then delaying the jump a bit, so you still have the dash because you're dashing on the ground, but you also have the momentum. It sounds complicated, and it is complicated. The last technique I was going to use was using dream blocks. In Chapter 2, Celeste introduced us to a new mechanic called dream blocks. Dream blocks are those weird blocks you can dash through them and get some momentum. Plus, your dash will automatically be regained. That's great, but in the B-side of Chapter 2, we are introduced to even better technique. This technique allows you to gain even more momentum from the dream block by jumping right at the end of the dream block, and that technique is quite easy actually. After learning this for another 15 minutes, I had only 15 minutes left. In those 15 minutes, I decided to think of shortcuts to the rooms. With my three new techniques, it wasn't long before I found one. In this room, you're supposed to do this, but if you use a hyper dash, you can make it a lot shorter. And in this room, you're supposed to do it like this, but if you use extended hyper dash, you can do it like this. I found more shortcuts like those, using the dream block technique, the hyper dash, and the extended hyper dash. The only problem, I didn't have a lot of time to practice them. For my last few minutes, I decided to do some practice runs. And the timer was off. Okay, now it's time for my final run. 2 minutes and 48 seconds. That was awesome. A 48 second improvement, that's absolutely crazy. I'm really surprised at what I could do in an hour. Was it a perfect run? Of course not. Was it the best run I could do? Of course not. But it was amazing for 1 hour. And who knows, maybe you'll see me next on those leaderboards. Thank you very much for watching.